this is a continuation of the previous video. So in the previous video we saw in this government of India there are three branches. First one is parliament, which makes laws. Second is government, it makes laws are followed. Okay, the third one is the court, which punishes people if people are not following the laws. Okay, next. And then I just showed the picture of the parliament also. Okay, this making fair laws, ensuring that the laws are obeyed by all, is very very important also. Okay, they say that the parliament, whatever laws made by the government, it has to be followed. And in this government there are two types of government. One is central, the other one is state. There are two types of government. One is central government, the other one is state government. So India has been divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. India has been divided into 28 states and 9 union territories because it is difficult to govern the entire country. There are many places. So all these places couldn't be governed by a single person. So what India has done, it has divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. For this reason, we have a central government also. One more is there, called as central government for the entire country. There are state governments for each state of country. So what happens, for each state there will be one government, that is state government. All these state government are governed by central government. Okay. Each state, 28 states and 9 union territories have their own individual government, and all these are governed by one government, that is called as central government. Okay. Law and order for the entire country is looked after by the central government. So there are no special law and order for different states. It is same for all these states and union territories, and it is governed by the central government. Members of the central government, such as president, prime minister and other ministers, live and work in the capital of India, New Delhi. So there are many many important persons. They are called as VIPs and ministers also. For each state there are ministers. Like that, all these state ministers join together and elect the prime ministers also. So there are prime ministers, next prime minister, president and other ministers for each department. They work, all these ministers work in the capital of India, which is the capital of India, New Delhi. Okay, each state government makes laws for the people living in that state. So what happens, each state, they have their own government. For example, we are in the Karnataka state. So our state is governed by our minister, okay, chief minister. Who's our chief minister? Mr. C.M. Yediyurappa. So that person looks after the Karnataka state, and he sees that laws and rules are followed. Whatever sent by the central government, he sees that that state is followed, particularly among them, among the people of Karnataka also. The governor and the chief minister are some of the members of the state government. The central and state governments together look after the needs of people in India. So what they do, the state government, central government, both join together and see that all people are followed by rules and regulations by the people of India. Each state and each member of the state, they